Dynamic hyperinflation is a complication of mechanical ventilation that occurs when a positive pressure remains in the alveoli at the end exhalation phase of the breathing cycle. It's often referred to as auto-PEEP, air trapping, intrinsic PEEP, and inadvertent PEEP. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Dynamic hyperinflation is usually caused by air trapping that results from an inadequate expiratory time. Therefore, if a patient's expiratory time is not long enough, air remains in the lungs, which results in dynamic hyperinflation. Remember that the best way to correct dynamic hyperinflation is to increase the expiratory time, allowing a complete exhalation. And you can do that by decreasing the respiratory rates, decreasing the inspiratory time, which can be done by increasing the flow, and by decreasing the tidal volume. Some other causes of dynamic hyperinflation include patient-ventilator asynchrony, a respiratory rate that is too high, a minute ventilation that is too high, and an expiratory time that is not long enough. As previously mentioned, auto-PEEP refers to a pressure in the alveoli at end exhalation that is above atmospheric pressure. It often occurs in patients with obstructive lung diseases that require a prolonged expiratory time, for example, patients with asthma or COPD. These patients' airways are obstructed or constricted, therefore they may have a difficult time fully exhaling the machine-delivered tidal volume before the next ventilator breath is delivered. When this occurs, gases from each delivered tidal volume ends up being trapped or retained in the lungs. That is why it's often referred to as air trapping or breath stacking. Now let's talk about some of the hazards. Dynamic hyperinflation can cause patient ventilator dyssynchrony, a decreased cardiac output, and in some cases, decreased blood pressure. If left uncorrected, it can even result in increased peak airway pressures that lead to barotrauma and ventilator-induced lung injuries. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching, have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.